stunned you all into silence. Excellent.
Julie. So I see some parallels here between like trying to evaluate creative enjoyment with game enjoyment. I'm curious if there's any parallels there with what people are doing, like reading managers have been doing.
Right. So we definitely reference a lot of Regan's work because she's got experience in doing this measurement. There's a strong difference though in that typically in games, you're trying to have this positive experience that's you're really interested in the challenge level and trying to keep them at that challenge level, but keep it positive typically, right? Artists actually don't care whether people have a positive experience, they just want a reaction, right? So there's a difference there. You can't sort of aim for positive valence. So, you know, there's definitely overlap, but there's also this way in which it diverges. So, but yeah, it's definitely relevant, and they have great experience with these metrics and sensors, so we're definitely relying on their experience with that.
I'm still trying to wrap my head around this a little bit, but say you apply this to something that's more of a static medium like painting. Mm-hmm. And I guess the reason I'm asking is because dance is more of a temporal thing?
Temporal, yeah.
Is there any sort of sequence involved there? I mean, is it like for exercise you might warm up, or you might have this endorphin thing at the end?
Well, so with the, we would be sort of looking at people who are digital artists, right? Because we're interested in creativity support tools. So people who paint in Photoshop, for example, might be something you're thinking of. So we could look at using the CSI, survey, right, and deploying that for, they use the GIMP, they use Photoshop, you know, which one scores better on various things. But in terms of the biometric, what we would look at is capturing their biometric during a session in which they're painting with Photoshop. So